Industrial Revolution, it started, I would say around the beginning of the 19th century with some precursors before, and before that, if you look at the time and how people lived there, basically like even from the ancient times until the outbreak of French Revolution, most people they lived in the agricultural sector. Yeah, like 80 to 95% of the population worked in sector in the medieval times, and the early modern times it was mostly like that, with a few exceptions maybe, but between 80 to 95% of the population, it doesn't matter if it was Germany or France or Great Britain or Russia, percentage of a population lived worked in the agricultural sector. But with the outbreak of the French Revolution, with the technological advancement, more and more left their land and went to the cities, and they worked for factories and companies and so on. Yeah, like I said before, what caused the revolution, the industrial revolution, and it is mostly a philosophical question, because during the Age of Enlightenment, new ideas came to the public. We should not always obey the government, and we should not always obey what the church says, and you probably learned it in school. Philosophers like Voltaire, Kant, Leibniz, Adam Smith, and so on. John Jacques Rousseau. want this cure and so whatsoever. And for that, the governments were no longer able to suppress new ideas, and they could not suppress new technologies. And for that, there was, yeah, you can say a technological boom, if you want to call it like that, because, I would say around 1750, Europe, it invented more and more and more things, and it became technologically more advanced. If you compare it to previous centuries before the 18th century, you will see that from that time on, Europe, and of course European influenced countries, they developed much faster than in previous centuries. So the agricultural sector, it slowly and slowly disappeared. The people, they left their lands. They settled into urban areas. That they no longer had to work for some kind of noble or aristocrat, but now they worked in a factory even longer hours, they had less free time, and they were not happy with that. Before the Industrial Revolution, the people worked for the peasants, they worked for nobles and aristocrats, and many say that the nobles and aristocrats oppressed them, which is true, of course, not in all cases, but they oppressed them. So the peasants, they moved into the cities, and they hoped that their life there would be better, but of course it did not took place. They often had to work up to 10 or even 15 hours a day in Germany when they adopted capitalism around 1840. I know that they had to work like 16 hours a day, even on Sunday. That's over 100 hours a week, of course. You can imagine that it's, slavery and torture, basically, and because of that, many were, of course, very angry because of that, and it also gave rise to communism, because communism promised them to social reforms and so on. But I think we can all say that in the beginning of capitalism, it was pure horror, the working conditions, but from decade to decade, the working hours became less, and people were at least industrial revolution, of course, started in Great Britain. It was the first country worldwide. Then, yeah, you can say the second country was France. And then, yeah, basically it was the USA. But the industrial revolution in Germany started much later, like with the reunification of the German Empire in 1871. Yeah, there were like pre-development in Prussia. They the Prussian king there, he adopted reforms that were highly influenced by Adam Smith, who was considered the founder of free market economy, capitalism. But really the industrial revolution took place in Germany with the beginning of the year 1871, when the German Empire was reunited. Yes. Now, to add a few more details into that, I mentioned before that before the Industrial Revolution, the people, they worked for on the land, yeah, in the agricultural sector, mostly for, yeah, not mostly, but in many cases for the nobility, for the aristocracy. There were also many peasants who had their own land and they worked for themselves. Yeah, but with the start of the Industrial Revolution, many people, many peasants, they moved into the cities. It caused a huge population increase, and the cities became overcrowded. Slums appeared. Yeah, it was in every European country, Germany, France, Great Britain, and also countries like the USA and so on. So, and many Marxist theorists say that it with it it only became worse with the Industrial Revolution and capitalism. It's all linked together, according to them, and they basically went from slavery into even more slavery, because when they, before the Industrial Revolution, they worked for the nobles, they were oppressed, okay, in many cases, but at least they, not all cases, but they had their land and they were not so oppressed like when they worked in factories on their land. They sometimes even had to work only 3 or 4 times a week, and now they had to work like 10 hours a day or even more. And many Marxist theorists say that it is complete, it was complete slavery, and it still is, because most countries today, they still have a capitalist system, or at least a mixed capitalist system. So, and to add a bit more, with the outbreak of the Industrial Revolution, I mentioned before, technology became more advanced. advanced, and there was basically a new invention every year, and we can see it the last every famous inventor or scientist that is well known today was basically born in the last 100 to 150 years. We don't really know that many inventors from previous time, like ancient Greeks or Roman Empire or the medieval times. We only know inventors from from the last 100 to 150 years. Not only with the technological advancement, especially for humanity, it became easier to work, but it also developed weapons of mass destruction like the atomic bomb and heavier war machinery and tools with whom you can enslave people. And there's a genre in literature about that. It's called cyberpunk. Movies like Terminator or Matrix, they are basically cyberpunk, and what they want to tell with it is that through the technological advancement, it did not really liberate humanity, but it rather enslaved it. My personal opinion about the Industrial Revolution, it is that, of course, you can say that the Industrial Revolution made it easier for humanity, at least in some things, because work became easier and so on, and the technological advancements became faster and faster. But we also have to admit that with the Industrial Revolution, humanity did not really become free. If you see it today, that many jobs that were natural, like, I don't know, 30 or 40 years ago, like carpenter, for example, I don't know about in your country, but it's in my country, in Germany, it's basically died out. Nobody wants to do this job anymore, and many don't want to learn a job where they work with their hands anymore, and this is very, very sad development. Like in my country of Germany, we also completely abandoned the coal economy. We had large coal mines in the Ruhr area, but it's basically completely abandoned now, and this is very sad because we did it for basically like more than 1,000 years. I think that's all. I'm over 20 minutes now. you bald